So thank you for hanging around. I don't know if this is on. Okay. So hello again. So this is the educational session, which seems to be now the forgotten session as well. And I will talk about different things I have encountered in teaching open in the geospatial context. My name is Václav Petráš. I usually go with Vašek. And I'm GrassGS developer. I have several other roles, like NC State student. And the disclaimer there is that I'm actually not speaking for NC State. I'm speaking for myself, so just keep that in mind. And I'm also NCSU Geo4All lab member, and I will tell you what that means. Geo4All, who has heard about it? I know some people did. Great. So for those who didn't, Geo4All is a network of researchers and educators who are organized around Open Source Geospatial Foundation and several other organizations like ISPRS. And the mission of this network is to make geospatial education and opportunities accessible to all. That's the mission statement. And what that means is that you have open everything. So you have open data, and to process this open data, you of course need open source software, so you actually have something which is accessible. But at the same time, this open data, it's not that simple. They have to be in open format, which is standardized, and so on and so on. So it's important to realize that there are these different parts of it. With open source, it seems to be now quite straightforward, in at least in some areas. In many industry areas, it seems that open source now is the norm. And we have even some companies like Red Hat, which are really leading the way and are working towards things like open organization and teaching about it, which connects to what we heard this morning in the keynote, to the collaborative leadership. In open science, that's the area I'm interested in a lot. It seems that there is a big consensus that everything must be open, at least what is possible for privacy reasons, of course. But we don't have the adoption there. But we are working towards that anyway. So, but what it comes to down to is teaching. So we have to teach the students. We have to learn ourselves. And very often, we have some requirements to do it. And what I have seen, the requirements are often that students need to know some enterprise software. And then at the same time, we want to minimize what the students actually have to learn to become experts in the field. And the result of these two requirements is that the students are taught a single proprietary software in whatever field they are. Of course, there is this jump, this assumption that enterprise and proprietary are the same thing. If you want to teach enterprise software, you need to teach proprietary software. That's of course not a correct assumption, but very often it's there. And there is of course some other assumptions as well. In North Carolina State University, if you go to the website in 2016, what you would see is that in a Center for Geospatial Analytics, which I am part of, we were offering 12 courses, and more than half of those would explicitly mention a proprietary software in their description. From those courses, these would be actually all the courses which somehow mention some software. And then some of those also mentioned some open something, not necessarily software, and one single course would mention open source software which is specific to the field. So not some general open source software, let's say like Linux, but something which is specific to our geospatial field. In this case, it was GrassJS. In the year 2017 now, when you look at the website, I think it improved actually. We still have the same courses offering, but the descriptions are now changed in the way that they actually don't specifically mention software except in two cases. And in one case, it's some proprietary software is still mentioned, but also open is mentioned. And that's actually improvement in the sense that the focus now is on what are the skills which you learn in the class, not necessarily the specific software. That's at least for the descriptions, not necessarily for the content of the course itself. So with the content of the course or having some open in the course, what I have also seen is that we would say, well, we are teaching open because we are teaching something like Python. But Python is not, is of course open source, but it's not specific to our geospatial field. And also, all programming languages are open source, or most of them are open source. So teaching a programming language which is open source, does it really count as open source? Maybe, maybe not. Same thing for teaching about OGC standards. Are they have open in their name, but of course they are standards. Everybody should use standards, the proprietary software, the open source software. So that's also not really such a big deal. So maybe what we should ask and say explicitly is why we are including open into the classes. We can see explicit including of open into classes in at the University of Kentucky. Maybe you have heard about New Maps Plus graduate program. I know some people talked about it here. So that specifically teaches some open source software, and that's part of the description of the courses, and it's really based around it. But at the same time, it's focused just on the web technologies. But there is more than just sharing the data on the web or maybe interacting with the data on the web. There is also analysis. So we need to, if we want to actually have students which know something about open source, open analysis, we need them to also learn about open source which can do analysis, not only visualization. And that goes even when we zoom into OpenStreetMap, where OpenStreetMap sometimes are used as an alternative to proprietary analytical software, but it's not really the case, right? OpenStreetMap is something else than software for analyzing data. How I would see OpenStreetMap in educational research in this context is, for example, this paper from Brovelli's research team, which was comparison of OpenStreetMap data with the authoritative raw data sets. And there it was combining both strong open source software like GrassJS for the analytical part, and then of course we have this strong part with OpenStreetMap. At North Carolina State University, where I am, we have now opened a new PhD program, which actually mentions specifically in some course descriptions, again, open source software or open options. But there is maybe the last thing in this way that we don't really have it as part of the vision. So it's not clear why the open source is suddenly part of these courses, because is it because it's a cool buzzword, or maybe we are on mission something like open science? We don't know. So at the lab I am part of, which is a small part of the Center for Geospatial Analytics at NCSU, we have this idea of how to teach these courses, which are mostly graduate level courses. And the idea is that we have lectures which teach the theory and concepts and the general things, and they are software independent. And then we have labs and assignments for the students, and there they actually use some software and relate that to the theory they learned in the lectures. However, it doesn't really work well. We have students who are becoming only software users, not really experts in their field. We can see that maybe examples like when they want to talk about vector data, they would say shapefile. So if OpenStreetMaps are open data, then they are shapefile. Of course not, so that doesn't really work. But that's somehow what happens when you are using one single software or maybe one single software vendor. You somehow get aligned with specific technologies, specific terminologies. And at the end, for the science, it's also important that if you are tied just to one software, you are just tied to this selection of algorithms, and you are not really ready to explore beyond that. So how we address this problem is that we require students to actually use two different software packages. Because if they would use one, open source or proprietary, they would be just tied to this one. But we give them to work on two different software packages, and they do their assignments in that. And the hope is that they will generalize the concept they find in one software and another software, generalize this on a higher level, and that can be connected to what they actually know from the lectures. We hope that this gives them the opportunity to actually choose in the future, and we know that some students who are leaving us and giving us feedback after years, they have this flexibility. This, of course, costs more time for students to actually work on it, but we believe it's worth it, so there is nothing we can do about it. The course which we teach this way is Geospatial Analytics and Modeling, and we have great experience in teaching this course since 2008. It's on campus and distance, and it works. So this seems to be a pattern which you can use. In this course, it's focused on data analysis and modeling, and for that, GraphGS is a great option, so we are using GraphGS, and also from the proprietary side, we have there ArcGIS. In another course, multidimensional geospatial modeling, that is an experimental course. We don't teach it every semester, and in that course, we actually go a step farther, and we use more experimental technologies. So the students use different software packages based on the projects they are working on. We worked a lot with GraphGS and some temporal data management tools. And we also used tangible landscape technology, which is a cool technology. You can learn about it on Sunday here in this room in the morning. So that's an advertisement for another workshop. In another course about UAV and LiDAR data analytics, this course is under development. We ran two semesters of that. And when we started, we were not really ready to use Open Drone Map or another open source things to process drone imagery. So we were using edges of Photoscan. So at this point, we are hoping that we will be able to work with both edges of Photoscan and Open Drone Map, again having these two different software packages, And Open Drone Map has been recently improved with Web ODM interface, and I believe you will be able to learn about it more in a talk by Dakota Benjamin again, this time on Saturday, again in this room. And then last course, the latest one we have developed is a course which is specifically focusing on tools for open science. And it's going through several different open science topics and specifically focusing on tools and software tools like Jupyter Notebooks or Docker for recomputability and reproducibility and many other tools related to that. The course is already online. All these resources, this course and actually all the other courses, we share all the teaching materials we are using online under Creative Commons license, so you are free to use it. The source code for that is on GitHub. And we are also trying to share it as much as possible, so we registered all the courses in the OSGEO Educational Content Inventory, which is now being redone for the new Open Source Geospatial Foundation website. In any case, you can find it on our GitHub, and feel free to use it and give us feedback. If you want to really dig deep into it, or maybe just read again what I was saying, there is a paper about some parts from what I was talking about. It's open access, so you can have it very easily, even if you are not part of some academic institution. And the last thing I want to talk about is data. So when we talk about data, let's talk first about OpenStreetMaps. So our lab, what we are teaching is graduate level courses, and the students, when they come to us, they usually already know OpenStreetMap, but very often they would think it's a name for S3 base layer. So that's very sad, and we unfortunately don't really have a power to work with these students when they actually encounter OpenStreetMap for the first time. When we work with them, it's for specific projects, and at that time we have opportunity to actually explain what OpenStreetMap is. What we don't have is a way how to systematically introduce it to all graduate students. So we are seeking ideas for introducing OpenStreetMap for graduate level courses. So like think master students and PhD students and their research projects. And the other part of the data we are working with is in terms of teaching is a data set which we are using for teaching all these different geospatial analytics classes or workshops on conferences, actually. And we had this idea that we create a general data set which can be used for all these different classes and workshops and also software documentation. So one thing was that we were trying to create something which is general. So very often when we create some sample data set, we just name our digital elevation model DM, sometimes elevation, sometimes SRTM, because that's the source of the data. So we just said, okay, let's simply have one name, elevation for all this data, and whether it is from this source, this sample data set, or that sample data set, it will be the same name. So we have all these standardized names. And then what you can see on the slide, there are some commands for GrassGS. We don't have to understand them now. This could be in Python or command line. And this will work on any data set which has these names. So the idea is that for each area you are in, you can create special data set. So for our students, we are creating one from North Carolina. But there is one data set for Czech Republic as well, one data set for Italy, and one data set for Puerto Rico. They have the same names, and you can run the same same analysis on it as long as the names are the same. The challenge, of course, is the language. So as long as it is in English, it works. But you can have some ideas there, maybe. The data sources for this are clear in case of buildings and roads and things like that. We use OpenStreetMap. Or in the US, we can also use government data. With orthophoto and digital elevation models, I would like to use Open Aerial Map and Open Topography. Didn't work out for our case, but hopefully in the future. And with that, I will just tell you that the main ideas are that we are teaching two different software packages. Then OpenStreetMap data for us are working as a data set, but also as a use case of how the things can be done collaboratively. And if you are not part of Geo4All, and you would like to be, talk to me. I can tell you what that would mean. It's very simple. There are no requirements. And that's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much.